My name's Rosie Curtis, and we're at McLean's Nose in Ardnamurrican, and behind me is my salmon farm. I live in the croft with my husband and my three children. Yeah, it's really important that we have a sheepdog because you do a lot of running about if you don't have a good sheepdog. Marsh, come here! I'm also the watch commander for the local fire team, deputy officer for the Coast Guard team, and I'm also involved in various other committees. In 1997, my dad became ill. I came home and helped my mum look after him. When he died, I decided that I was going to stay in Kilchoan. There was a farm tech job going, so I applied, and 24 years on, I'm still here producing Scottish fine salmon. We're all working to the ASC standard. We will be independently audited, and at any time, any auditor can turn up on your site unannounced. It's not easy to get into, it's quite difficult, but we are working really hard. It proves to people out there that I care about my environment, I care about how I look after my fish. I'm very passionate about what I do. At the moment it's summer, so we are probably about 6 weeks away from our first harvest, and then we'll become fallow, and then we'll start all over again in November. It'll take anywhere between 11 and 18 months until the salmon leave us at 5 kilos. There's a lot of signs going into the pens. So, you know, we've got 120 metre pens. Our nets are 17 metres deep. We have got between 40 and 50,000 fish in a pen at the moment. Just over 1 million fish at McLean's Nose. Each shift have got some health observers on site, and we also have two local vets that are based in Fort William. So they come out to the site once a week and we keep in close contact with them. So in here we've got an anaesthetic that we put our fish into, and within a few seconds then they'll be anaesthetised. And that gives us a chance then to check gills, lice counts.
Clean fish there, Rosie.
And also today Anna's doing some bloods. And then we'll get them back into pen as soon as. And it's less stress for the fish if they are sleeping for this procedure. So yeah, this fish is a beautiful fish and it's got lovely gills. And even better, my lovely Ras is doing a fantastic job because it's got no lice. Ras, known as cleaner fish, they will eat the lice off the salmon, and it's something that they do in the wild. We have artificial kelp in the pens to make the ras feel as if they're in their own environment. So we look after them, they look after us. Every pen's got a camera, so when the fish are being fed, the person monitoring the feed can then switch the feed machine on and off when the fish have had enough. Of course, it's the environment, you know, we don't want feed going to the bottom of the seabed. It's important for us to clean our nets because you don't have weed growing in your nets, so you've got a nice flow of water going through, but you get a good quality fish from having good quality water. Our net washer, it's remote control, and it's also got cameras on it, so your whole net is checked. It's a bit like a PlayStation. You know, you just have to look in the pens and you can see, you know, the fish are not crowded, they're shoaling, they're eating. You can see the behaviour on the cameras. When you pull up at the pen with the boat, the fish know you're coming. And people laugh at me when I say that, but it's true. Staff welfare is really important when your weather conditions are challenging. As a manager, we have to make sure that everybody's safety is their number one priority when they step in the boat in the morning, full concentration until you take your last step onto the shore base in the afternoon. There's 12 staff work at McLean's Nose. There's two of us in the fire team, and there's also two in the Coast Guard team. It's a big commitment for companies to release staff because you don't know when there's going to be a fire or there's going to be a Coast Guard call. When your pager goes off, you can go. The population in West Ardnamurrican is 247. It is an ageing community, and having fish farming in remote rural areas, hopefully, you know, in the future, that will help encourage people back into communities and keep our communities alive. Hopefully, in a couple of years' time, the whole of the salmon industry will be credited with ASC. You know, it's a tough, tough certificate to get, so I will display my certificate with pride.